Sorry, don't nurse it.
Thank you. been a while.
Thank you.
You've
been spending how long?
It was
beautiful. Yeah?
Thank you.
Are you
sending it to the Chinese? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You don't regret so far?
Not yet.
Take your time.
Good.
Okay, guys.
Happy to see you. You're back.
If I could ask, please, as usual, if you guys could use the raise hand function so we know where we're going with these virtual questions. We're going to start with Simon Stern from the BBC. Simon, I'm going to allow you to talk.
Hi, Pep.
Hi.
How is your squad, given all the internationals, and has everybody come back fit and coronavirus free?
Yes, they come back, everyone. They come back a little bit better than the previous time before, because the previous time Cancelo, Bernardo Silva and another one were injured and they could not play the beginning of the season. And unfortunately, Kevin is out. But the rest of the players, they come back well.
What is the extent of Kevin's injury?
I don't know. I don't think it's much, but next games I think will be out. But we'll see day by day how it's going on.
How long, when you say next games, you have a lot of games coming up?
Everyone has a lot of games, every team, yeah.
No, but how long do you think how many games might you make?
I cannot answer you these questions because I don't know.
And just on Sergio Aguero, I've seen pictures of him training. Is he fit to play?
He's training well and we are happy. We need, of course, every team needs a striker. We play without them. First days, 3-4 days, training well, good. Happy to see him back on the pitch after a long, long time. So happy.
Thank you, Simon. Ian Abrahams from TalkSport.
Hi, Pep. How are you doing?
Good. You?
Yeah, good, thank you. We always talk, whenever you take on Mikel Arteta, we talk about the master and the apprentice, because obviously Mikel sat next to you for a long time and probably learned an awful lot from you. How well do you think he's done? He was mentioned in Arsene Wenger's book about doing really well. How well do you think he's done?
Well, first, maybe we should clarify who's the master, who's the apprentice first. And the second one... We didn't, I think, all the people who knows him, we didn't have any doubts about what he's doing in a short period of time. He settled really well, in a special way his team, Arsenal, is playing right now. He suits perfect for the quality they have. And he was able to get back, Arsenal get back in the position where for a long, long time ago. So... and it's, you know, doing really well in all competitions and being a team like he has Mikel ADN, like a competitor and a fighter and clear things to do on the pitch and I think of the pitch. And all the people who lost him, we are more than happy that what he's doing in London.
Next we'll go to Subhayan Chakrabarti.
Hi, Pep. I have two questions for you. First being, now that all the players are fit, Cancelo, Benjamin Mendy and Zinchenko, all three of are fit, what is your preference of left back? And my second question is, you had a lovely interaction with Virat Kohli this week. So what was it like?
Sorry. Oh, yeah. Start for the second. It was a pleasure to meet him. So I'm not a big... understandable man about cricket. So I've never saw one match, but thanks to Puma to organize this event and meet him. And maybe it was a good opportunity to present myself and give opportunity to go to India, like I've never been before. And when this pandemic situation finished, maybe we had the chance to go there. But it was nice. I know for the info I have, how important is Virat from Indian culture for the cricket. He's a legend there and an incredible, huge competitor and a serial winner. So yeah, it was nice. It was a real nice chat. So thanks to Puma to give me this opportunity. I'm more than delighted personally as a club to be partner from Puma, because I discovered incredible people working here in this organization. And the first one about left back, it depends of the game. It depends of the performance for each play, for the performance for each player in the terms of physical condition, the tension, the many, many things. And it depends of these. I take a decision which one is going to play.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pep. Cheers.
Next we go to Emma Saunders. Emma?
Hi, Pep. It's been a crazy start to this Premier League season, hasn't it? So many goals across the entire Premier League. Do you expect things to slow down a little at all?
Yes.
And why is that? Do you think these teams will benefit from the break we've just had?
Because in the beginning of the season, all the teams, they had more the tendency to bore more courage to play. And step by step, I think the people is going to take care a little bit themselves a little bit more, but hopefully we can continue like this. For the spectators, for the football itself, is nice. See a lot of goals, but it's exceptional. Maybe for the situation, an exceptional situation that all around the world the people are living. But I suppose see these 6, 7, 8 goals per game every weekend, it's not normal. So, but maybe it's going to happen. Maybe I'm wrong, but I think maybe it's going to settle normally in the future, in the next times. So we'll be injured a lot. We'll be a lot of games, many, many teams, especially the teams who play in Europe. There are many, many, many games in a short time of preparation. So that's why it will be difficult to know exactly what is going on.
Okay, next we go to James Cooper. James.
Hi, Pep. Sorry, good afternoon. I know managers don't like international breaks because their players go away, but was this a good break because it gives your players more football when there wasn't a proper pre-season?
Yeah, no, I never complain about the international game. So I know how important it is for the players, for their own nationalities, for their own country. It's an honor and it's a privilege. So. And they have to do it. And of course, the UEFA and FIFA defend their own tournaments and happen, and like a Premier League defend own tournaments. So always we want the players come back fit, no injuries, but sometimes can injure here training with us. So sometimes you cannot control. I am more than opinion that the players are injured because we demand a lot to the players without time for refresh their minds, their bodies after tough seasons. And that's why arrive a moment the human body and the body said, oh, it's enough, you know, and that's why sometimes they fell down. But that's in the part you are right. So Bernardo and the other players, they could not take, Joao and other players, they could not have a normal preseason. It was injured in these games to take a rhythm was good for them, really good.
And in the last week, Pep, there's been a lot of talk about a big picture, about the responsibility of bigger clubs, perhaps to help smaller clubs in this country. What are your thoughts on those suggestions, Pep?
I want the best for the football world, so the best for English football. So I don't know. I don't have an opinion because first I didn't listen much about what they suggest or hypothetically suggest is this club. So what I want is the best football. I'm a big fan for the low categories. I came from the low categories. So the League One, League Two, in Spain, so in Catalonia, so that's why always we can do. But honestly, I don't know exactly what is the situation. I know in any changes it happened. I remember I was in Catalonia with Barcelona, and he in England arrived the Premier League. And it was an incredible lot of criticism about the Premier League. In that terms, we say, no, it would not be good. We have to stay like we were before. And after what happened in the Premier League, is maybe the best league in many, many reasons in the world. So, but I don't have opinion. Only what I want is the best for the football, support the Premier League, make it stronger as possible. Now it's not possible because COVID and this pandemic is not possible. But of course, for the local categories, because the old towns, the little village, they love their own teams, and that is the point. So I'm pretty sure they will find the best solution for the football, England football, or the football itself.
Thank you, James. Final question for the embargo from Fred Caldera.
Hello, Pep. You said that you expected Gabriel to be back after the international break. How is he doing? Is he ready for tomorrow?
No.
Do you think he's going to
be ready? There is some injuries in some muscles that you can take a risk, but there are another ones and you cannot. And Gabriel has an injury in the front part of his leg, like he's if he's reincident in this injury, we will lose him for a long, long time. So that's why you have to be careful.
So how long do you predict that you need to be careful for? So Champions League, he's not playing again as well?
I don't know.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you, Fred. Guys, we're calling in about...